Who are you?
I'm Whitney Cummings.
Whitney Cummings, welcome to Auburn, Washington.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for doing this interview with me. Can you give a shout out to Hannibal Buress right there for setting it all up?
Hannibal, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey. Can you come over here, Hannibal?
Hey, what's up?
Come over here, Hannibal.
Hi.
Thank you so much for setting up this interview.
Thank you. Please don't give Whitney a panic attack, because then it'll... don't make me unproud.
What can you tell the people about Whitney?
I can tell them that Whitney is an amazing comedian, and based on her stand-up material, she's rich and she fucks broke dudes, and she doesn't like what they say about them potentially having babies or her having their baby, and she works hard and she crushes shit.
And Whitney, what can you say about Hannibal?
Big fan. Love him. I basically went away to do a TV show for a year and I came back and he was an A-list star, and he wears V-necks like no other.
And in appreciation, Hannibal, of you setting up this interview with Whitney, I have a gift for you.
Yeah?
I have right here the signed version of the Wu-Tang manual.
Oh, thank you. What is the manual about?
You'll learn all about the Wu-Tang Clan. RZA, an autograph.
Found it. That is awesome.
An autograph. And also, because you're from Chicago, I have this for you right here. Chicago Rocktober fanzine right here.
This is the Chicago Public Access Dance Show.
Yes, and they have a TV show, and they also have a magazine called Rocktober, and this is the Comedy and Novelty Records issue.
I didn't know that, man.
And you're in it. They review all your records.
Really?
And you can also read about Neil Hamburger and Jimmy Lynch in the history of comedy.
I don't know who Jimmy Lynch is. That's a crazy gift, Nardwuar.
This actually is a great gift.
And these are gifts to thank Hannibal for setting up the interview with you, Whitney.
I'd like to give him a gift to say fuck you for setting up this interview.
Ba-boom!
Well, thank you. I'm about to get out of here and get on stage, man.
Hannibal, one quick question. Yeah. You tweeted out something that said, no shorts, no hats, no Jordans. Where was that? The place you couldn't wear Jordans?
It's a lot of places that'll say that they'll have a dress code that kind of leans towards keeping black males out. So they'll say, no white t-shirts. No. So it was a place. It was just funny that they said no Jordans, but they didn't say, oh, you could wear no Jordans, but you could wear LeBrons or Kobe's. It was funny that they made it specific to Jordans instead of gym shoes.
Well, thanks so much for setting up this Whitney interview, Hannibal.
No problem, Nardwuar. Be cool.
Keep on rocking in the free world and doot-doot-a-loot-doot.
Doot-doot.
And it's amazing here on the Oddball Fest, isn't it?
Yes, it's magical.
It's amazing who is around here, and who should we see over there?
My hero!
What can you tell the person? What can you tell the people about this person?
That she's my spirit animal, and there's nothing funny about it. I have no jokes. I just sincerely love her.
And you were the person known as?
Sarah Silverman.
Berg.
Sarah Silverman, welcome to Auburn, Washington.
Oh, I'm so happy to be here.
Sarah?
Yes?
I have a gift for you, Sarah, right here, because you are a female comedian. I thought it's important to wrap out right here. We have a gift for you. What can you tell the people about moms?
The first ever comedian of stand-up comedy, Moms Mabley.
That's an amazing gift. You do give amazing gifts.
And it's signed by Ted Latte.
Ted Little?
Who's that?
Who's Ted Little? Someone Google that.
I think it's just like the guy who has this record store, maybe, or the guy who...
His real name.
And we'll have to thank Tom Sharpling, because he's the one that told you about me.
What is it with people? They just say statements and then put this in my fucking face. No,
Tom Sharpling, though. I mean, what more can be said? Tom Sharpling.
Tom Sharpling, great guy, great writer, great radio personality. Monk.
And what can you tell the people about Hannibal, who we just saw here, Sarah?
He is what you call black.
Affirmative.
And what can you tell the people about Whitney?
And he's brilliant, and he's hilarious, and we've been spending a lot of time together, and it's enjoyable. What can I tell you about Whitney? Nobody deserves success more than Whitney Cummings. She works her ass off. She's hilarious. She knows her way around a joke. She's got the skin of a dove. And I say that not really knowing what's under those white feathers of a dove. But I feel like maybe I'm thinking of dove soap. I don't know. Why is this wet?
I don't know. I'm sweating.
I don't like when people give me things and then they're like wet.
It could be Nard sweat. Or it could be squirt.
Do you need me for this interview?
I
can totally. Should I come back?
You did talk about squirting, though.
I did talk about squirting, yes, sir.
And on that note, thanks so much, Sarah Silverman. I really appreciate you dropping by. And And here we...
Sorry, Sarah. And I love you.
Is it true, Whitney, that you once auditioned in a towel?
I once... You really Googled deep. You Googled hard. I did one time, it was my first audition in Los Angeles, and I didn't know what I was supposed to be doing. And the role was for a girl who was in a spa. And so I wanted to look as much like I was in a spa as possible. So I showed up to the audition in a towel, naked, underneath the... I thought I was like being like a method actress or something. In reality, I was just stupid. And I showed up and everyone was in like jeans and like normal. And I auditioned. I got it. I think they just felt so sorry for me. They thought I was like, you know, a Make-A-Wish kid or something.
Whitney, you gave up showering.
I gave up showering.
You gave up showering.
Are you just deducing that based on the way I smell right now?
No, in why men go gay in...
L.A. Why did you what? Okay, so is this your thing? You just find the most esoteric things? I haven't thought about that in 8 years. I don't remember. Was that a movie or a show? Or like,
I think it was a short.
It was like a short film. I don't remember anything about it. It was like I was on a date or something. Wow, you're really an encyclopedic knowledge of crappy Whitney Cummings works.
What products were you paid to do test focusing with?
That's a good question. God, you are really good at this, actually. I did Neutrogena. Like when I was broke, I used to do like product testing for like, you know, you go in and you get like $50 cash. It's you and a bunch of like meth addicts who just want like money. And I went in and it was for Neutrogena. It was for like a face scrub and like a little machine that you could scrub your face with. And I always wanted to do a good job, so I was always the person who was like, I feel like this could be like a little like scented different, and everyone else was like, just shut up. So I would always get in little like passive aggressive arguments with the drug addicts who were just trying to get $50 cash.
Thank you, Banyan Productions.
Oh my gosh, how do you know all this stuff? Banyan Productions, that's when I was in college. I used to work for this production company in Philadelphia that did like a bunch of TLC shows. They would pay me to like be the person that would audition with the people auditioning.
Whitney Campbell, Christy Hinman, Bethany McHugh, and Katie Dennehy.
How do you know that? Where do you, like, what's happening?
Roanoke Catholic Celtic.
Like I might start crying. Oh my God. These are literally like some of my best friends from like when I was in like eighth grade. Bethany McHugh was my Bethany McHugh was my best friend in when I went to Roanoke Catholic. Christy Henman, oh my gosh, was ahead of me a year, and she was like a really good basketball player and soccer player, and everybody loved her and she was awesome. And the other one, I don't know.
And you were on the team with them.
I was on the team, yeah. We played basketball. I played basketball. I was really into basketball.
Did you score a lot, Whitney?
I was pretty good. I got better, but I was more of a like strategizing, like knock people down, rebound type.
And you were on the grade 9 honor roll with Elizabeth Warnick?
Elizabeth Warnick. I haven't seen Elizabeth Warnick 20 years? That must be 20 years ago.
And the grade 10 honor roll with Hillary Lewis?
How did you find... Does Google just have all this stuff? Or, I mean, you're amazing. Do you get paid for this?
You're Whitney Cummings. We have to know this stuff.
This is so crazy. Well, I just have to say, most interviews, like, I dread them, and you probably sense that from me in the beginning because you answer the same questions over and over again, and people ask about the same things. You started on Punk'd, you did What's It Like Being a Woman in Comedy? It's like the same questions and it gets so monotonous and you're like blowing my mind right now.
Whitney, here we are in Auburn, Washington.
Yeah, hi.
And oh my God, who do I see over there? Who is that?
Oh my gosh.
I was just hanging in the corner of your dressing room. Did you not see me here the whole time?
So weird. You just like appeared out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Who are you?
Oh, I'm Chris Hardwick. But I've been watching you for like a decade and a half.
Please tell me about the drunk calling, Chris.
In the late 1900s, I got really drunk one night, and I called Nardwuar, and I'm like, you're amazing. You have to. I was working at MTV at the time. I'm like, you have to come on MTV. Have you seen any of the interviews? Have you seen any of the this man's a legend.
I mean, no, I've seen them online, and Hannibal told me I had to do this, and it was like Jay-Z and Drake. And
which Russian president did you say keep on rocking in the free world to in Russian?
Mikhail Gorbachev. Dershny rockin' u slobodny svet. But I want to thank you, Chris, because Chris drunk called me in like 1995 or 1993. Remember? How did you get the you got my stuff on VHS tape?
Yeah, I watched your stuff on VHS tape, which was a way that we used to watch things in those days.
How did you get the VHS tape?
I don't remember. It was floating around MTV, and I had it, and I became obsessed with it. I became obsessed with your interviews.
And Chris tried to get me on Singled Out.
I did.
Oh, I would have liked to see that.
Yeah, we could play it right now.
What happened? No, I just continue on. Like, you got this VHS tape, and then you ended up phoning me?
I did. I phoned you, and I was like, you have to come on MTV or something, and then I don't know what happened after that. Then I stopped being drunk. I don't know what happened, but honestly, I've been such a fan of yours for so many years, and so now I get to see you in person. This is
an honor. It's such an honor, Whitney. In the middle of the night, I get a phone call, and it's Chris. I mean, we're two drunk writers. I think there was somebody else that said that we're drunk.
Yeah. He used to go around with Kurt and Courtney and like do all these crazy. It was phenomenal. Yeah, I wish I still had that tape.
And then, like, you phoned me in the middle of the night, and I was like, oh my God, this is incredible. And you're like, I'm going to put you on Singled Out.
That's right. See, most dudes like drunk dial girls. They want to fuck. I drunk dialed Nardwuar, the human serviette, and I didn't get fucked. So it was, but it still
you
worked.
You would have done great on Singled Out.
All right, back to your interview. Oh,
thanks so much, Chris, and Chris, come over here. Thanks so much again, and doot doo. It's amazing, Whitney, all the people at this Oddball Fest you're jumping into.
I know. Well, you really, you're a big draw. People want to talk to you.
Whitney Cummings, I have a gift for you here. Right here. It is Gil Scott-Heron.
How do you...
And Jamie.
Wait. What?
Jamie XX. You love them, don't you?
No, I do, but how do you know that? How do you know that? Did I say this somewhere? Are we falling in love?
You love vinyl.
Are we together now? Wait, okay, so how do you know this? Have you been in my house?
I just know that growing up you wanted to be Sarah McLachlan's songwriter.
I did.
So you love vinyl. You love Jamie XX. What can you say about Jamie XX and Gil Scott-Heron?
I mean, I just, New York is Killing Me is one of my favorites. I just like have it on a loop, but why, this is so cool. Yeah, no, I'm here's the thing. I'm not great at receiving gifts. A lot of comedians aren't great at receiving any kind of love or nice thing. So I'm really just kind of trying to figure out how much I owe you for giving me this.
Were you into Joanna Wendt at all?
How do you know that? I'm obsessed with Joanna Wendt.
I can tell the people Joanna Wendt.
I'm going to stop like being surprised by your awesome questions. Okay, Joanna Wendt is a performance artist who I met her husband in LA a while ago, and that's how I kind of got turned on her. I was writing a movie about a performance artist and got into her work and just kind of got obsessed. She, you know, is just this fearless, ballsy woman who goes on stage and just loses her mind and dresses like a vagina and just covers herself in blood and is just kind of awesome.
Whitney Cummings, is James Dean your favorite male porn star?
You know what? He's the only male porn star I know, but so I would have to say yes, I guess, yes.
And you have his anal trainer kit?
I have his anal trainer kit. Chelsea Handler gave it to me. That bitch. And
explain.
You know, look, Chelsea's mental illnesses are far and wide, and I'll never be able to comprehend why you would send someone an anal trainer kit. And it was open, by the way, like it was like kind of used, but that's just who she is. And then I Googled James Dean, and his dick is two different colors, which I thought was interesting. Like it's like two-tone, which is fine. I'm just like impressed by someone who's like, oh yeah, I have a two-color dick. I'm gonna become the biggest porn star. Like, I respect that.
You know a lot about sex, don't you, Whitney?
I don't. I actually don't. I talk a lot about it because I know so little about it. Like
tonight, there was some squirting.
Yeah, I talked about squirting, but I talked about how I don't squirt.
But tell me about the oral sex light. The oral sex light.
Oral sex light?
There's an oral sex light.
Light where someone can, look, if it's that dark.
It straps onto your head.
No, I'm not okay with that. I don't want anyone magnifying or light. This light's already causing me anxiety. I certainly don't want that. I would like to keep it as dark and as possible.
Whitney, I thought it was interesting. You Googled hypnotize a man so he won't leave me.
Yes.
And the results were a stone love, some sort of egg set.
Oh, the thing you put in your vagina, those balls, Benoit balls, was it that? Those ones? Yeah, no, I can't get behind those either. See, I'm really not a slutty person. Now, you're making me realize that I'm pretty demure.
But you were on Dave's Old Porn with Ron Jeremy. Did you meet Ron Jeremy?
I met Ron Jeremy. He's a lovely man. He did not try to have sex with me, which is pretty insulting. But yeah, Dave Attell is, you know, one of my favorite comedians and favorite people. And so I just did the show and I was horrified by the porn I saw.
Whitney Cummings, Rittenhouse Square.
Lived in Rittenhouse Square when I lived in Philadelphia. This is like a pop quiz on my own life. Rittenhouse Square in Philadelphia.
And you lived in the Sterling Apartments?
I lived in the... how would you know that? Yes, I lived in the Sterling Apartments.
Whitney Cummings, you like Bistro Francais in D.C.?
So, okay, how do you know that? That's weird. This is a restaurant that me and my family would go to like regularly in D.C. I don't even know if it's still open. That was like my favorite restaurant in Georgetown. It's called Bistro Francais. I don't know. I've never mentioned that in an interview, I don't think. Have I?
Well, thanks so much, Whitney Cummings. Anything else you want to add to the people out there at all?
I'm getting a restraining order because there's no way you haven't been in my house and through my cell phone. Are you the hacker? Are you who's been releasing all these nude photos into the cloud?
Why should people care about Whitney Cummings? Why should people care?
I love that you're just so nonlinear. Why should people care? I mean, look, I'm not, if you care, you care. If you don't, there's nothing I can do. I'm powerless over your caring about me, but, if you don't, it'll break my heart. No guilt.
Well, thanks much, Whitney. Keep on rocking in the free world.
Thank
and you. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
Doo-doo.
Yeah.
Is this the deal? We just... Doo-doo. Doo. You're so weird.